Hi everybody, I'm trying to make this short. With this first project, we're exploring photography, identity. We're also exploring Instagram. I don't mind if you use Flickr, particularly for preliminary postings. I think it's actually a better format than Instagram for that sort of dialogue. But I do want your final photos on Instagram. Now this might bring up some problems. I'm not sure what most of you are using. Are most of you using your phone or using a camera like I'm talking into? Or heck, are you shooting 35 and developing? I don't know. I'm open to all of it. But I do want the final photographs to be up on Instagram. If you're manipulating photographs on your computer and you want to put them on Instagram, there are a few more hoops to jump through. Instagram really is designed for this platform, taking photographs on your phone and immediately uploading them to there. So if you're using your computer, I posted on one of our threads a guide from CNET on how to get images up to on the Instagram. So, do that. It's okay. I am curious as to why you like certain social media, or what you don't like about certain social media. Why are you posting things on Flickr? Why are you posting them on Instagram? What do you like about one or the other? What's better? What's the strengths? What the weaknesses? What frustrates you? I can tell you from my own experience, I prefer Flickr simply because I've been using it a long time and it functions very much as a photographer. I'm still in that making things. I still like to make images. I don't know if you can see this. This is a Auratone. It's a silver gelatin print on glass with a gold background. Auratones are well over 100 years old. But you know, I still like to make things. I often make things and then I post them up on Flickr. Instagram, it's a bit, you gotta jump through some hoops there, and I don't know the program well. I don't know if I can organize them in different ways. So, you know, I'm fairly new to Instagram, but it's one of the things I found I needed to change in this course to keep it more up to date. Honestly, more students are using Instagram, certainly, than Flickr. Flickr is, you know, pretty low at this point. I still use it because I like the format. But more students, you know, those teenagers, early 20s, are using Instagram than are using Facebook. You know, Facebook's sort of going away and becoming for old people. And I think there's a lot of reasons for that. One is, you know, so much is contained. Instagram's designed for this, and this is what our students have. They may not have a computer at home. They may not have a camera, you know, big DSLR at home. Or maybe they do, but maybe it's their parents, and their parents watch it or whatever. But, you know, this is easy, quick, fairly cheap. And it's not just, you know, students here, but people across the world have much easier access to a phone with a camera on it and social media than they do a big computer with programming and expensive cameras. You know, so this is really part of that sort of democratization of photography, which photography's always evolved towards a democratic use, in my opinion. But so make sure we're exploring Instagram. I don't mind using Flickr for preliminary explorations, but the finished stuff needs to be on Instagram. And also explore some of the filters in Instagram. Yeah, I think they're a little bit cheesy personally, but I also think I need to check my opinion on that, because you know, not everyone has access to this stuff, and ultimately it's the visuals of the image that matter. It doesn't matter if I, you know, go into the dark room and spend lots of time doing things photochemically. Mostly it's the end product that speaks. So make sure you're exploring those things. If you have any questions or opinions on any of these things, you know, post them on Canvas. Let's have a conversation.